Hello students. So today we will talk about propositional logic. Now what is logic? Logic is a truth preserving system of inference. And inference means that you derive new statements from old statements. And what is a proposition? Proposition is a statement that is either true or it's false. So suppose I say this is a video on knowledge representation. You could say it is true or false. If I ask you today is Sunday, you may say it's false or you may say it's true if it was Sunday. So such statements where there is a true or a false element, they are considered as a proposition. Yeah. But for certain questions, you know, why does it rain? It's not a question of true or false here. You know, what a great book if I make such a statement. There is nothing about true and false in these two lines. So these two lines are not examples of proposition, whereas the first two are examples of proposition. Now what is a paradox? Now paradox is things which have two meanings. For instance, there's a thing called as a liar's paradox. And this line, can you tell me whether it's true or false? This statement is not true. That is a line which I'm stating. Now, if this statement is true, then the statement itself is saying it's not true. And if I say it's false, then this statement is true. So in a way, this statement is a confusing statement because in a way it is two possible ways I can consider this. So due to which it's called the liar's paradox. So paradox are also not considered as proposition. Okay. So we talked about what is proposition and what is logic. Now let's move to something which is called as a truth table. And truth table is basically related to operations like and, or. Yeah. So suppose I say Rajesh likes maths. Okay. So that is one statement I'm making. It's a proposition I'm making. Now I can apply these operations on this. I could say not in front of the statement Rajesh likes maths, and it will become Rajesh does not like maths. So when there are two conditions in Excel, for instance, we can apply functions like or, we can apply functions like and we can combine two conditions. For instance, if I say who are the students who have got above 40 marks and less than 80 marks. So there I have two conditions and there's an and operator in between. Okay. I may use an or condition and say who are the students who got either 16 or 17 marks. So there are two marks, 16 or 17, and I'm considering these two. So there are examples, and you may have done it in the Excel video where we talked about and or. In C programming, on the other hand, we have a symbol with two pipes and two ampersand in the case of and two pipe symbols in the case of or. In proposition logic, we have certain symbols which are marked in yellow here, and these symbols we'll be using in this particular unit 3, as we study about knowledge representation. We'll talk about these different symbols which are there. So many of you may have done it during school days when we did truth tables. So suppose I say false and false. Now false and false will give you false, right? Because it is both are false. So and condition will give you false. Suppose I ask you, suppose you are from Karnataka and you are above 16 years of age. So I may ask you the question, are you from Karnataka and are you above the age of 16? In which case both the statements are true. And because both the statements are true, your answer is true. Yes, in the case of and. But suppose you are actually 13 years old, then one of the statements will become false. So when one of the statements is false, we can't say and. I mean, in the and situation, both of them will give you false. So for the and case, we will get false in three cases. we'll get true only in one case when both the conditions are true. Okay, so that's the only case when AND will give a true. Okay, on the other hand, suppose I ask the question, are you greater than 16 years old or are you from Karnataka? So either you are from Karnataka or you are 16 years old, and if neither of them is true, obviously OR will also give you false. But if one of them is true and you are saying OR, are you greater than 16 or are you from Karnataka, if any one of them is true, you will say true. Similarly, if one of them is true, you can still say true, and obviously if both of them are true, we can write true. And we can check this in Excel. I would have done it using a function called AND. I could have said we will do the same thing here. Let us check in Excel if I used AND, and in Excel if I used OR. Let's see what happens. So I could have said is equal to AND, and I could have given this statement, comma, this statement. And as expected, false and false gives false. And if I drag this thing down, you will notice it is the same thing as we got here. So this one, is same as this one, what we got in Excel. Yeah, obviously it's the same function, we will get the same thing as expected. And the case of OR, I could say is equal to OR, and I could do this comma this, and we'll get false false false, or we'll get false true true true. So you will notice this one is very similar to this one. Yeah, so we can straight away see these two have come out same and the other two have come out same. So that's the meaning of AND, and this is the meaning of OR. Okay, what is NOT? NOT is basically the opposite of whatever we are saying. So suppose the input one we are studying, if it is false, it will return true. It's just checking one of the two things. So if I say NOT, then whatever is there in the input, the opposite of that will come true. If the input is true, it will give the output as false. So we have some symbols which we are studying today. The first one is called the AND symbol. We talked about the OR symbol and the NOT symbol. Another way we call these symbols are conjunction. And these terms we should know: conjunction, disjunction, and negation. So in a way it's a logic, but how do we represent logic is what we discussed in this first video. I walked you through how Excel does it, and we could have simple examples. For instance, I could say, let's say M. Rajesh likes maths, and suppose I want to say Rajesh doesn't like maths, so I have to simply say NOT. And I have to put the symbol NOT in front of M, and that will mean Rajesh doesn't like maths. Suppose I want to use the AND symbol, I could use a statement like, does Rajesh like maths and Rajesh like psychology? So does he like both maths and psychology? Then we will use the symbol AND. If he likes only one of them, we could use the symbol OR. So these symbols are useful, and we should be able to interpret it. In the next video, we will take two examples and try to walk through some examples to understand how to use these symbols to represent knowledge using propositional logic. Thank you, students.